is because Africa is a shattered world, and its fragments are scattered all over this globe. It is therefore impossible to study Africa simply by looking at Africa itself. In fact, a lot of early Africa has disappeared and survives, in fact, in the life and civilization of other peoples. One is very much aware of this, for example, when one is in Brazil or in Haiti. I was in Brazil and in Haiti in 1981. In 1981, I was studying voodoo in Haiti, and I was particularly struck by the way in which various African elements that had entered voodoo had, as it were, dynamically intertwined with things that had happened in the New World, and yet it retained an African dimension. But no one in Africa itself, going into Dahomey, where Vodun originally originated, could actually study Vodun in all of its aspects without going to Haiti. The same thing I found in Brazil, that when I went into the temple of the great high priestess, black high priestess, in Bahia, I was aware that there were Yoruba rituals in Brazil that preserved intact what had already been destroyed in Africa. So that in a world where a tremendous shattering has occurred, a cataclysm has occurred, a Holocaust has occurred, a Holocaust far more terrifying than the Jewish Holocaust, it is impossible to go back and find intact anywhere the cultural heritage of that world. You have got to go back through other places, other things, not only Africa itself. Hence the attempt to synthesize the African presence in the world by going through Europe, America and Asia has been absolutely necessary. But this presents particular difficulty for any one person because no one scholar can master all three continents. Asia is the one I am weakest in. I spent 10.5 years in Europe. I spent time in Africa. I spent a great part of my life in North and South America. I've spent now almost as much time in North America as in South America. Asia is the only place I have never visited. And that is very strange because the radio in my country opens in the morning in Hindustani. I have lived in Hindu villages. Guyana is a very strange country, the land from which I come, because it's one of those few black-dominated countries in the world which has more Indians than Africans. 52% of my country is Indian, not American Indian, East Indians from Asia. And the curious thing was that the struggle we had at the beginning, and this is probably what led to my neglect of Asia, the struggle we had in the beginning, we fought very hard to weld the African and Indian population together because it is only by that unity that we felt we could defeat the British. As a result of which, our party was composed of Africans and Indians. The Indian was the leader because the largest population was Indian. So our first prime minister was an Indian, Cherry Jagan. And later on, when a struggle developed in the party, Jagan lost and Burnham, the black, became our prime minister and then president for life. At the moment, our prime minister is still black and our cabinet is composed of Indians, that is Asians and Africans. So that the Asian element is something very important in my personal life. But because it was the reason why I was sent into exile, it is something that part of me has tried to forget. Because after the tremendous attempt to weld the Asiatics and Africans in my country, an attempt that failed when the British eventually imprisoned most of us, we had a civil war in which Africans killed hundreds of Indians and Indians killed hundreds of Africans. And it's at that point, just before the breakout, I was in information services. I was very much aware of what was going to happen. I had my fingers on the nerve of the country. I knew exactly what was going to happen. And I knew that if I stayed, I would be killed. And as a result of that, I left home. And even though I have returned at odd times, I was really thrown into permanent exile because of this feud between the Asian and African. If only we knew our history. If only we knew how late we were. Not simply in the fact that we had a common enemy in the British, but if we only knew how profoundly the Asian and the African was linked, that kind of tragedy might have been averted.